4 a.m. I've struggled for the last hour to fall back asleep, but I can't. Yet again, I'm tossing and turning, unable to shut down my brain. Why? Because I'm stressed. I'm stressed about my students. I'm so stressed that the only thing I can think to do is to take my thoughts and write them down tonight and vow to myself that tomorrow I'm going to tell students the truth, the real truth I've been needing to say. This is what students really need to hear. First, you need to know that I care about you. In fact, I may care about you more than you care about yourself. And I care about you more than your grades and your test scores, more than your GPAs and your SATs, more than the state-required benchmark minimum that tells me how much I'm supposed to care. I care about you as a person. And because I care, I need to be honest with you. Do I have your permission to be honest both in what I say and how I say it? Here's the thing. Teachers lose sleep because of you every week. But before I tell you why, there's something you need to understand about school. You see, academic learning is not the main event of school. It never has been, and it probably never will be. Yes, algebra, essay writing, the judicial process, Spanish, all are important. All can change your life. They are events, but they are not the main event. The main event of school is dealing with the harshness of life, learning how to deal with adversity, learning how to deal with harshness as simple as a forgotten locker combination, to obnoxious peers, to gossip, to being doubted by others, to doubting yourself, and still through all of it, pushing to be the best version of yourself no matter what. The main event of school is conquering adversity. It is your resilience and conquering the main event, adversity, that truly prepares you for life after school. Because mark my words, school is not the last time you will face great difficulty. Yes, you will have moments more beautiful than you can imagine, but you will also confront tragedy, frustration, fear, and doubt in the years to come. You shouldn't be worried about the fact that you will face great adversities. You should be worried because you are setting yourself up to fail at overcoming them. Here's the real reason why teachers lose sleep because of you every single week. You are failing the main event of school. You are quitting. And you may not think you are quitting, but you are, because quitting wears many masks. For some of you, quitting looks like throwing the day away and not even picking up a pencil to try to write a sentence or a fraction because you think you can't, or it doesn't matter, or it's not worth it, but it is. What you write is not the main event. The fact that you choose to take charge of your own doubt, your own weakness, your own boredom in order to write when you get challenged, that is the main event. Some of you quit by skipping class on a free education, a privilege that was paid for, bled for, died for by millions of people who came before you. Being punctual is not the main event. The main event is delaying your temptation and investing in your own intelligence, understanding that sometimes short-term pain leads to long-term gain, and that great people make great sacrifices for a greater good. For others, you quit by throwing disrespect at adults who ask you to go to class. Bowing to authority is not the main event. The main event is learning how to problem solve maturely, not letting your judgment be tainted by the stains of emotion. It's having grace and tact when every fiber of your being wants to hit or scream or run away. I see some of you quit by not taking opportunities, chances after chances after chances, to pass a class. The main event is not having some letter, some number tell you that you are worthy. The main event is pulling your crap together and making hard choices and hard sacrifices, even when it seems impossible. It's finding hope in the hopeless, courage in the chasm, guts in the grave. What you need to see is that every time you take the easy way out, you are building a habit of quitting, and it will destroy your future and annihilate your happiness if you let it. Our society couldn't care less for quitters. Life will leave you sad, depressed, and poor if you can't courage up and learn how to deal with hardship. You are either the muscle or the dirt. You either take resistance and grow stronger, or you erode in the wind. So know this right now. As long as you're in my life, I'm not gonna let quitting be easy for you. I'm going to challenge you, confront you, push you, coach you. You can whine, you can throw a tantrum, you can stomp and scream and swear, and guess what? Tomorrow, I'll be right here, smiling and patient, waiting for you to give you a fresh start, because you are worth it. So do yourself a favor, courage up. No more excuses, no more justifications, no blaming, no quitting. Lift your head up, rip the cords out of your ears, grab the frickin' pencil, and let's do this.